Let's now try to do some practical guides around what we discussed. So we can see that H1 DOM object 1, if we have to get, we can write document.getElementById and provide the ID, which is heading 1. And if we do a console.log, we will be able to get the value. So this particular thing is getElementById. Now the second, getElementByClassName. Again, let's write H2, or maybe we will give it a name called DOM object by class name equal to document.getElementsByClassName and give the class name, which is group 1. We will again do a console.log DOM object by class name. Let us give it a name, objects, because we are going to get a array. We also call this array as HTML collection, but you can say that for most of the purposes, on a simplification level, it is an array. And then we can also get elements by tag name. Let DOM objects by, this time we will give it a name, tag name equal to document.getElementsByTagName. And provide the tag that you want to get and just do a console.log of this value also. Let us now try to open this in the browser. And let's open the console for comparison. And here we are. We can see that the first value represents the H1 tag and it is coming from this line. The second one is an HTML collection, which is coming from this console, and the third one is coming from line number 23. Now, let us try to again look at the collection, and here we can see what? We can see that it is giving me two values because we have two elements that correspond to this selection criteria. Because there are two elements with the class equal to group 1. And the third one will give me 3. Why 3? Because here we are having 3 elements which satisfy the criteria. So let's try to again just quickly do a comparison. In the sense, just mark this is the console which is coming from this line. The second is this one, and the third is here, right? So that is all. One is by ID, then class name and tag name. And both these return us an HTML collection or an array.